Good morning, our saviors. Ooh, that is loud. I like it. I like it. The power is coursing through me. It is good to see you this morning. There's all sorts of stuff going on in the life of our church. Events keep happening, and Pastor Tim and Lisa returned from their trip, so we're excited to hear a sermon from Grandpa Tim this morning. And you'll get to hear and see more about their new grandchild, their first grandchild. And then my oldest son, Elijah, and I have returned from our travels as well. So we trust that things went well last Sunday with Pastor Ron Mock graciously filling in, preaching and presiding, and that you guys didn't like call a congregational meeting and change all the rules of the church while we were gone, right? Everything's still good. Okay. Building's still standing. All is well. So I invite you to stand as we continue with confession and forgiveness. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who greets us in this and every season, whose word never fails, whose promise is sure. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of our neighbors. Merciful God,
at all levels, national, state, and province, and local, to work for justice, mercy, and reconciliation. Hear us, O God. God of compassion, you bring healing to those who are sick, consolation to those who are grieving, and well-being to those who are distraught. Send skilled caregivers to all in need, especially Scott and Anne, Bev and Nick. Make your presence known among all who suffer. Hear us, O God. God of rejoicing, you have brought us together this day to worship around word and sacrament. Encourage children in their learning and growing, and watch over those who are absent today. Lead us all to places of renewal and refreshment. Hear us, O God. God of all faithfulness, through the witness of the faithfully departed, you reveal love in action. We pray for Ann Nelson and family, as well as Tony Clemmie and his family on the death of their mothers. Bring comfort and healing to them as they dwell in the midst of their grief. Embolden us to be their example to build up the beloved community in all the contexts we encounter. Hear us, O God. Into your hands, O God, we commend all for whom we pray. In the name of the one who reconciled all creation to himself, Jesus Christ, our Savior.
Amen. Now the peace of the Lord be with you always. Share that peace with each other.
Thank you.
God of field and forest, sea and sky, you are the giver of all good things. Sustain us with these gifts of your creation and multiply your graciousness in us, that the world may be fed with your love through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
This morning we had a little bit of a snafu with communion not being ready yet, so we have a couple people in the sacristy putting communion together for us. So I've been instructed to give them just a minute. So I'll give you your communion instructions very slowly. I will say, you could probably turn my volume down just a little bit on my microphone here. On our travels with this last week, when Elijah and I went down to visit my family, my parents and siblings at this lake house in western Kentucky, we had a song that the kids were singing, you know, kids these days, and so Tim said, sing a hymn or something to stall, and all I could think of was this song that the kids were singing that some of you may know that went, L-O-L-L-I-P-O-P spells, lollipop, lollipop. And so I've got this, you know, kids these days and their silly songs. So I've got this in my head since the moment I wake up this morning, and I keep humming it. So during the sermon, I'm thinking about lollipops as Pastor Tim is speaking about sin. And I'm thinking, yes, I know. So it's been a really odd morning for me this morning. And so that whole thing is sort of continued here as we have where we pause for a moment. So I'll give you a couple moments to sort of prepare yourself for communion. You may choose to sort of sit and reflect for a moment, but I will give you our instructions, which during this service, as you know, we have recently been practicing communion at the rail. So when it comes time for communion, the ushers will dismiss you down the center aisle. You'll come up to the rail, and if you can kneel, you can kneel right there and receive communion. Hold out your hand. If you cannot kneel, that's okay. You can remain standing, and we'll give you communion as you're standing. And then if you need the gluten-free option, we'll have gluten-free right here in the middle, and you can pick that up on the way to the communion rail if you have that dietary restriction. And so it looks as though we are about ready to go. So I invite you to stand. Dear friends in Christ, in the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and he gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. All people are called to Christ's table, so come, eat what is good. You may be seated.
Well, Now may the body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen.
We thank you, generous God, for the refreshment we have received at your banquet table. Send us now to spread your generosity into all the world through the one who is our greatest, dearest treasure, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
Well, as I mentioned earlier, all kinds of things going on at church, even in the summertime. So you've noticed as you came in that the welcome desk has all sorts of sign-up sheets. And there's some of that I especially want to draw your attention to. Most urgently, there is the OSLC golf outing. If you are a golfer or would like to learn how to golf, you can go. That will be on Sunday, July 16th, which is next Sunday at 2 p.m. But the deadline to sign up is today. So if you'd like to go, get your name on that list out there in the narthex today. The week after that or 2 weeks after that, is Saturday, July 29th. It's also a fellowship event. We're going to the Mallards game. So the Madison Mallards Baseball Club will be going and watching one of their games there on the north side of Madison. And the RSVP to sign up for that is Saturday, July 22nd. So that's just here in a couple weeks. So make sure that you go and sign up for that on the new link that Ed Nowicki sent out to everybody in your Crossroads email. We also are still accepting registrations for VBS, Vacation Bible School. And so that'll be coming up here in just a couple weeks, really. Starts at the very end of July and goes into that first week of August. And so you can sign up out there, you yourself, or for a kid or grandkid or niece or nephew or someone like that. And then finally, we will be doing the Cornfest Parade this year again. And so the evangelism team is looking for